My official name is Jegathesan, anak lelaki NM Vasagam alias Manika Vasagam. It's quite a mouthful, and clearly that is not how most people would like to address me. I'm known officially as Jegathesan or Dr. Jegathesan, and friends and people who know me, as well as even the media, sometimes refers to me as Jega or Dr. Jega. However, people here in Malaysia as well as otherwise may also perhaps refer to me more familiarly and more often as a former sprint champion, or you know, with accolades such as the fastest man in Asia, or as the flying doctor, with reference to my sprinting prowess in the 60s, for a period of 8 years, I was the Asian sprint champion, winning gold medals in Asian Games as well as participating in 3 Olympic Games and setting national records, one of which is still unbroken until today. I was introduced to the sporting environment very early, simply because my father and my elder brothers had a sporting inclination. My father was the first non-British athletic champion in this country when Malaya was then a British colony. I went to secondary school in Singapore. I quickly emerged as an athlete of some standing and became the Singapore athletic champion for 400 meters around 1958-1959, and that started off my international career. Although, because I'm from Malaya, I continue to represent Malaya, subsequently Malaysia. So in this way, I participated in various regional games like the Southeast Asia Peninsula Games, as well as the Asian Games, the Commonwealth Games, and also 3 Olympic Games. The one in Rome in 1960, when I went as a schoolboy, secondary schoolboy. Then again in 1964 in Tokyo, I went as a medical student. And in 1968 in Mexico City, I was already a qualified doctor, and I went to these 3 games as a participant. My very first Olympics was in the 1960 Rome Games, when I was just a 16-year-old boy, leaving the country for almost the very first time. Everything was very awesome, you know, and then once you reach the Olympic venue, everything is such a grand scale and you feel so small and sometimes a little terrified. But at the same time, you get swept up, you know, in the aura and the atmosphere and the ambience. In the Mexico Olympic Games, I reached the semi-final of the 200 meters, in which I established the national record of 20.92 seconds in 1968, which is still a national record in Malaysia today. Mexico was, of course, my third Olympic Games, but clearly that was the one where I did my best. And I remember participating and being in the company of great athletes like the American athletes, Tommy Smith, Joe Carlos, part of the Black Power movement. And you know, for their own reason, they decided to make a demonstration of their belief at the victory ceremony. You would remember the pictures. And of course, it caused a lot of problem for them. Now, these were the 3 I went as a participant. Rome, Tokyo, Mexico, and then after that as a team doctor, these 2, then as a volunteer in the Seoul Olympics, then as a team leader, a chef de mission, member of the International Olympic Committee Medical Commission, as well as research team. In those days, there is no income to be derived from sport. So you got to think seriously of getting a job, working good at the job, raising a family. So you find a good opportunity to quit. And generally speaking, it was always nice to quit before somebody beat you, you know. You quit at the top because you carry that image with it. And then after that, you focus. And that's what I did. So at the age of 24, I decided to focus on my medical career. And so I decided, and at that point in time, I was unbeaten in Asia in the 200 meters. So I thought it was a good time to quit after the Mexico Olympics, having set a new national record. Today, sportspersons are different. They will try to prolong the sports career as long as they can, because each participation could potentially bring in even appearance money and prize money and endorsements. So you prolong this lucrative career for as long as you can, until people tell you to stop. This year is going to be particularly interesting, because I've never known in my association with the Olympic Games till 1960, an Olympic Games that faced with so many challenges. Apart from local domestic challenges of politics, economy, you're also challenged by epidemiology in the terms of a virus everybody is getting scared about, the Zika virus. And you know, on top of that, there's this big story about the you know, doping allegations. So all in all, this appears to be one of the Olympic Games that really facing many challenges. But at the end of the day, somehow in the true spirit or the true genre of Olympic Games, in the end, I believe it will be pulled off quite successfully, and everybody will go there, have a good time, and go home and remember it.